Now in this lecture, we're going to talk more about lists. And we're going to see that most of the things we can do with arrays, we can do the same way with lists. And the first thing that is the same is how we can access individual elements inside our list. So again, we can use this square bracket notation to access, for example, the first element. So let's quickly get rid of all the output up here. And now I'm just going to print this first element inside our list. And of course, that's going to give us Patrick. Now, another thing that is really handy with lists is that we can also concatenate them using the plus sign. So if I create another list and make that an array list of Peter, I can simply concatenate them by typing in my array list plus my other list. And that's going to give me a list that contains each of these elements. Now, similarly, we can also use the size property that you already know. So this is going to give us the total number of elements inside our list. And also we can use the isEmpty function. And the last of the functions we've seen so far that is the same is that we can use the contains function, which is going to tell us if a particular element is inside our list. So let's go for Sarah. All right, so those are all the things that function the same way when we use lists. And now let's look at the differences when using lists. So first of all, as we have a mutable list here, so this is an array list, we can actually add elements to our list, and we can use the add function to do that. So I can just add Josh, for example. So in this case, Josh will be the fourth element in our list, so it's just going to be appended to the list. If we want to add an element at a certain position in our list, we can also use the add function, but we have to specify another parameter here first, and that is the index at which we want our element to be inserted in. So let's say we want to add another element at the second position, so we're going to specify a 1 as we start counting at 0, and then we can specify the element we want to add, so let's say Jack. Now if we print our new list that we have just changed, we can check what has been done. So before we had Patrick, Michael, and Sarah in our list. And now first, Josh has been appended to the end of the list. So that's still the last element. And just like we wanted, Jack is actually at the second position now. So that's how we can add elements to our lists. And similarly, we can also remove elements by calling the remove function. And in here, because we have a list of strings, we can just specify the string we want to remove. So let's say we want to remove Michael from the list. And just print this again to check. And now this is going to give us the same list, but without Michael inside it. Now both of these functions, add and remove, both actually also return a Boolean value. And this Boolean value tells you if the list has actually changed due to the addition or the removal. But more interesting is when we use the remove, because that's going to tell us if that element has actually been inside our list. So if we want to remove an element that's not even in our list, then what's going to happen is it's going to return false, so that we can check if our list has actually changed due to what we tried to remove. So this is going to give us false because Josephine was not in the list, so it couldn't be removed. If I switch this back to Michael again and test this another time, this is going to give me true because Michael was removed from my list. All right, so those are the two most important functions for lists, which allow us to add and remove elements from our list. And the last function I'd like to talk about in this lecture is called sublist. And sublist allows us to pick just certain elements out of our list from a start index to an end index. So let's create a value sublist, and we're going to set this to our list.sublist, and the first parameter is the index to start from. So if we want to start from the very beginning of the list, we could put a 0 here. And now for this example, I start at the second element. And the toIndex specifies the end of our sublist. And notice that the end index is exclusive. So the element at the position we specify here, for example, the fourth position, means that the fourth element will not be in our sublist. So this will be a list containing just the second and the third element. If we specify a 2 here, this is not going to contain the third element of our list, but just the second one, because we start at the second position and we only go one step from there. If you're having trouble figuring this out, you can actually just look at the difference between these two. In this case, it's 1. So you know that the resulting sublist only has one element. Similarly, this is 4 minus 1, so the resulting list would have 3 elements. Maybe that's going to help you in figuring out what the sublist is going to be. So let's just try this out for now. And of course, I have to still print it out, which I forgot. So let's print out our sublist, run this again. And this is going to give us just the list from our second element, which was Jack right here, all the way to the fourth element. All right, so those are all the main functions you need to know to work with lists. And again, please just try all this out for yourself. And if you have any trouble with anything, just ask me in the discussions and I'll answer you as soon as I can. Thanks so much for watching. If you've learned something new in this video, please make sure to give it a like. And also, if you're new here, hit the subscribe button and the bell icon to be notified of any new tutorials. If you want to watch more, check over here, and I will see you in the next video.